In late December 2016, one-fifth of Ukraine's capital city of Kiev lost power. No phone chargers, no Christmas lights, no electric heat. We now know that Russian allied hackers used a malware called Crash Override to disrupt the system. And with some modifications, it might be able to disrupt the US electrical system too. The incident in Kiev was only one of a handful of times a cyber weapon has been used successfully to attack a country's infrastructure. What is a cyber weapon? We typically think of it as pieces of code or malware that can do damage through a computer system. Like when the US and Israel created a computer worm called Stuxnet that forced 1,000 of Iran's 6,000 nuclear centrifuges to spin out of control, rendering them useless. Or when hackers turned out the lights on Kiev. And just before he left office, President Barack Obama signed off on a secret plan to plant digital bombs in Russia's infrastructure. The project was still in its planning stage when President Trump took office. The US, Israel, Russia, China, North Korea, and Iran have cyber weaponry at their disposal. But there are still some questions about what is and isn't a cyber weapon. Does the damage have to be physical, or can it be economic? And what about information stolen and leaked over the internet? Is that a weapon? Senator John McCain has said the Russian hacking and influence campaign during the 2016 election amounted to an act of war, which could challenge the way we think about weapons in cyberspace. But some say this is an act of espionage, not war, meaning Russia's meddling would not violate the UN Charter's prohibition on the use of force. The definition gets a little more complex when we talk about intent. Homeland Security Advisor Tom Bossert said these exploitative pieces of code are more like hammers than they are missiles, meaning that in the right hands, they can do good, but they become weapons when the person controlling them intends to do harm. Some lawmakers want the Trump administration to establish what they call a cyber doctrine. It would outline how and why the US can use cyber weapons, giving adversaries an idea of where the US draws the line and what they can expect if they cross it. But it's not clear what that would look like, how strict it would be, or whether it would apply to US interactions with specific countries or with the entire world.